guess he already knows it.
No, ask him to be sure. Hey, Chris.
Yeah?
What sharks are at the top of the food chain? Bull sharks?
Well, gray whites are the biggest. Well, they're not the biggest, but they're definitely the most aggressive and one of the largest sharks. So it would be, shark-wise, it would be the great white. And then you have, like, probably between the tiger shark and the bull shark. Yeah. But the gray whites are the nastiest. Bull sharks are pretty mean. I would say gray white and bull shark, and then the tiger shark. I think the bull shark, they have the most reported attacks on people.
Yeah.
Primarily because they do go up in freshwater areas as well, and so a lot of people are afraid of them for that reason. You know, but they tend to be more on the nasty side. Yeah.
Thank you.
Because of the head, there will be more resistance when they have to go fast in a straight line.
Yeah, they're not the fastest sharks swimming straight, but they're, like I said, the best maneuvering. And what they do is, when it comes to fish that are faster than them, which a lot of fish are, if they really want to, take it down, they have a high endurance, so they chase the fish for a longer time, and they have more stamina, so the fish will get tired, and they'll slowly catch up to it, you know, so they'll just chase it and chase it until the fish gets tired. Yeah. You got a question, buddy?
Where did they get the name hammerhead shark?
Oh, it's just the head because it's so, you know, it kind of looks like a hammer that you hit nails with. It has that hammer shape.
He's getting really close to you.
Yeah, I used to go in the water with him.
You get bit?
No.
You get scared, they get too close?
But I stopped before
you
I got
the hammer.
Smart man. So how old do they get?
Primarily of shrimp, squid, sardines, smaller bits and pieces like that, which they can consume pretty easily. This big guy right here is known as the Goliath grouper. Okay, that's the one that I fed at first. Okay, he'll probably be back. Yeah, but that's one of our biggest fish that we have here in the exhibit, apart from our sharks.
Sorry, quick question.
Go ahead.
Is that a tunnel underneath?
That is a viewing tunnel. To access it, you guys, there's a staircase in the center of that restaurant.
Okay.
You go down this staircase and they'll take you to the 100-foot viewing tunnel. Alright?
Okay.
Good, yeah.
With the view underneath too. Okay?
Christian, what kind of fish are these?
These ones right here, we got a good mix-up going on right now. The ones that are closest to me, the smaller ones towards the reef, are grunts. They're called Margate grunts. There's a big fish right here that's a black grouper. On the outskirts, you have the longer ones. Those guys are called the tarpon. And then on the outskirts, there's another group of fish with their fins sticking up out of the water. Those guys are known as the jacks. Okay?
These?
Go ahead.
These are long thin ones?
Those are
the needles.
Get fed three times a week?
Twice a day.
Twice a day.
Twice a day.
What's the other time of the feeding?
We'll be back again at 3 o'clock.
3 o'clock. Please.
Yeah. Okay.
that one.
We didn't catch any of
them. This one's from the southern stingray up there in the shallows, as well as some sawfish. So I spread the food around to make sure that they don't have to compete with each other for it. Every once in a while, the nurse shark will go up into the shallows as well. But right here, you can see the southern stingray, as well as the sawfish for right now. I don't see anything else at the moment.
I don't see a stingray. I see a dolphin.
Yeah, that's what the shark sees, right? Those big chunks.
Thank you. Look at the shark.
You're welcome.
Oh.
Baby shark.
Okay, so no, those.
No, there'll be more.
I see another one.
Yeah, I see it.
section right here. The smaller one is roughly around 11 feet. The larger shark is roughly about 12 feet long. The male's now been known to get up to 16 feet a day.
Are they aggressive?
They can be at times, but they're not, you know, like the great white shark.
There are so many bubbles over here. Is it a good thing? The bubbles on the surface.
Yeah, that's fresh water. The water comes up. And sometimes the crop on top of the water, it's just a combination of algae and stuff like that in the water, and it gives off. I don't really know what to call it, but it's from the water coming in and from the waterfall, so the algae starts to grow. So it happens from time to time, but it's not something that's common.
Do they fight one another?
They do chase each other. I don't think necessarily fight, but they definitely do chase each other around sometimes.
I missed it. That's the bigger one.
Yeah.
Whoa. Do they ever jump out of the water? Like, not the hammerheads, right?
They might stick their head out from time to time, but that's about it.
These are the hammerheads.
Yep.
Primarily, it's a result of the shape of their head, which acts as a steering device. It kind of turns the property.